Unbelievable, actually, but it happened. A cop grooms a child, travels multiple states to kidnap this child, ends up killing the family, gets into a shootout, and gets killed himself. I'll put up his picture full mass here. Damn shame. A member of law enforcement from Virginia died in a shootout with law enforcement in California after a suspected cross-country catfishing effort to sexually exploit a teenager left three of the girl's family members dead. Austin Lee Edwards, 28 years of age, you're looking at him, traveled from Virginia to Riverside, abducted a 15-year-old child. He met this child online, killed her mother and grandparents. He also set fire to the family's home before leaving with the girl. Now look at this guy, right? Remember, I've always said corruption is never linear. It always has tentacles in other areas. So you think he's only corrupt against 15-year-olds? You think he only is corrupt because he murders? No, no, there's a lot more corruption connected to him, I guarantee you. The victims were identified, 69-year-old Mark Wanick and 65-year-old wife Sharon, and their daughter, 38 years of age, Brooke. So sad. Detectives determined Edwards had met the female teenager through the common form of online deception known as catfishing, where someone pretends to be a different person than they actually are. The Riverside Police Department said, police said that it was believed Officer Edwards developed a relationship online with the teenager and was able to obtain her personal information. Authorities believe Officer Edwards parked his vehicle in a neighbor's driveway, walked to the home, killed the family members before leaving with the child. Dispatchers were alerted to smoke and possible structure fire a few houses away from the disturbance. The Riverside Fire Department discovered three adults laying in the front entryway and took them outside, where rescue personnel determined they were victims of an apparent homicide. This is how the teen was rescued. When deputies with the San Bernardino County Sheriff's Department called up to Edwards, the suspect fired gunshots before being fatally shot by at least one deputy, police said. Edwards was pronounced dead at the scene. The teen was not physically harmed and was placed into protective custody, according to the cops. Let me give you some background on Edwards, all right? He was an officer for the Virginia State Police. Then he was hired by Washington County Sheriff's Office, according to a report in the Press Enterprise newspaper of the Inland Empire. His time in law enforcement lasted less than a year. But during his application process, training and time on the job, he passed the physical, he passed the psychological, and written tests, as well as a lie detector test, according to Virginia State Police spokesperson Corrine Geller. Corrine, you already know what's up, okay? You think he really took a lie detector test? You think those records are accurate? He didn't pass a lie detector test, ma'am, okay? They lied. I hope you are okay with an investigation being launched into the practices of vetting with that police department, because there's a lot more problematic dynamics here. He changed jobs within 1 year of being an officer. Now, I'm not ready to report on the why yet, still waiting on confirmation, but it may be a good idea to actually check out why he was no longer a cop in the previous division. All right, Sharon, thoughts here.
So if we believe the spokesperson, who's absolutely either lying or has goofball information in, then there's nothing you can do about these things. They're gonna happen all the time. There's nothing you can do to prevent bad cops from putting on a uniform. That's not true. You've talked often on this show on Indisputable about psychological testing. So I don't believe he passed that either, Dr. Richey.
Yeah.
This whole thing has to do with this man is beast. How we got here though, there's a whole football team full of people who have to be held accountable.
You're absolutely correct. And I question obviously the validity of a psychological evaluation that this guy could pass. And naturally, I don't believe it was a legitimate lie detector test at all. All right, we'll give you an update as it comes.